next, a matchup for the UFC Women's Bantamweight Division title. Well, this is a belt that has changed hands quite a bit, and this number one bantamweight contender believes it will again here tonight as she makes the walk for this title fight. She believes this title shot should have come earlier. She's not caught up in all that now, hasn't been during fight week. She's focused on the champion, and you see her staring her down right now. Crowd going crazy. She believes she is the best bantamweight in the world and believes in a matter of moments here, she will be the new champion. Changed hands quite a bit, but not since it's been held down by this young woman, the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion of the world. She has really set the standard for excellence at 135 pounds. Tonight, though, facing a number one contender that comes in with a lot of momentum. So if she can defend the belt yet again here tonight, it would really go a long way in stamping her legacy as one of the greatest bantamweight fighters and champions of all time. Our tale of the tape for this women's bantamweight championship fight. 2 years apart, these two fighters. Some differences in height and reach as well. Now for the official introductions, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Mergliotta. This is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Toyota Center in Houston, Texas, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC bantamweight Championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This woman is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 11 wins, 5 losses. She stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Kansas City, Missouri, USA, presenting the challenger, Megan Anderson. And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 21 wins, 4 losses. She stands 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Miami, Florida.
All right, this is for the UFC championship. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. I want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out fighting.
Here we go, UFC Women's Bantamweight title is on the line. Nunes gets caught with that punch, gotta shore up the defense here. All right, so Amanda Nunes getting off here again as usual, really as well-rounded a fighter as we have in the men's or the women's game here in 2020.
Yeah, regardless of gender, right? Regardless of gender, Amanda Nunes stands amongst the best in pound-for-pound in the entire UFC.
Timing her shots nicely here tonight, DC.
She's doing a great job, but not only being active, she is so accurate. She's on point tonight. Ooh, what a punch. Look at the force behind that leg kick.
Well, she talked a lot about the path of least resistance being the clinch. And she clinches here.
And watch for her to start to mix in that great judo background that we've seen her do on so many different occasions.
So again, they will clinch here. Oh, big kick for her there. Oh! Swing and a miss with that punch by Nunes.
You don't know when that leg kicks coming.
Ooh, up
with, oh! You can never know what you're gonna see with this young lady. Is she gonna finish the fight?
Strikes have already landed for Amanda Nunes. Under 3 minutes now to go in the round. All right, so again, we find ourselves here in the clinch where there are obviously no shortage of subtleties and nuances, a lot of motions in here that maybe are lost on the casual fan.
Absolutely, and it's gonna be the underhook. For all the things that happen in this position, the person winning and controlling the underhook battle is the one out ahead.
Nunes' knee strike is blocked. Battle for position here.
Right hand punches the clinch.
Oh, nice punch there by Nunes.
Nice body kick right on the elbow.
All right, so the fighters are in the clinch again, DC. I get tired just watching these situations.
It's exhausting. This is a position where you are constantly draining at the gas tank of your opponent. Big punch from the clinch.
Able to land to the body there with the left kick. That's a perfect scramble right there. Beautiful transition. Oh, beautiful straight punch there. She is putting it all together here tonight. She caught the leg earlier, maybe might have gone for the takedown, but in this instance, she chooses to punch out. Nicely done. She's starting to put together some significant body work here, and these are going to take their toll as this fight goes on. Oh!
She is such a diverse striker that big strike landed, and it looks like she's going to finish this fight.
Trying to stay in this fight! Stuffs the takedown, no problem.
Oh!
Big knee! All right, so no surprise, once again, we find ourselves here in this clinch situation. We'll see who can advance.
Who's gonna be the person to dictate the pressure? Who's gonna control the engagement from this 50-50 position?
All right, 45 seconds now to go on the round. Submission defense there. And she connects with a punch there, champ.
She's so accurate. She's so good at timing all of her strikes. Right hand punch with the clinch. There's no give on that leg kick.
That's a beautiful jab by her there. We'll see if she can follow it up.
If you fight behind such a beautiful jab, eventually you drop the right hand, good night.
Uppercut to the head. Instead, it's blocked by Nunes. All right, so a lot of strike absorption by her in that previous round. She got stunned on the feet, but survives to see another round. Talk us through the replay, man.
You look at the action here. They're going back and forth, and boom, there goes that big strike that lands that really does hurt her opponent. She could not find the follow-up shot, but eventually she will find that moment.
Second round on the way. She continues to work the body here to great effect. Stuffs that takedown attempt without issue. Oh, nice job by her landing knee to the body. Her size advantage certainly helped on that exchange. Oh!
Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
Oh!
Oh! You can never know what you're gonna see lady, is she going to finish the fight?
Well, she did not miss a single grappling practice during this training camp, and here's your evidence. Outstanding. Man, this is not a fighter who you want around your neck. She goes for the guillotine here.
Oh, nice guillotine there.
Oh, look at this. Jumps over in the side mount to try to counter the guillotine. Maybe going with that Von Flute choke, or I guess we should probably call it the OSP at this point. And there it is!
It's over! It's over! What a fight!
Yeah, really nice job by her there to execute the submission. Clearly she had an opening and she closed the show pretty effectively there. That is one of the bigger wins of her UFC career. So there she is, celebrating with her corner, the queen of the 135ers, the UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion. And how about the method of victory tonight as she gets it done by submission?
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bermiotta has called a stop in this contest at 1:17 of round number 2 for the winner by submission.
Submission win here tonight. She remains the UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion. A lot of people thought this was a qualified, credentialed number one contender, and she was, but she proved no match for the champion here tonight, and the celebration is on. Hard to blame them after this result here tonight. Congratulations to the